So here I have taken next word, which is irrigation. So how can we define irrigation? Timely, or I can write supply of water to the crops in a particular amount and intervals. Okay, just now I told irrigation means supply water, but it doesn't mean just supplying of water at any time. Supply of water in right quantity at right time, okay, is and right way. This is very, very important, and it is only known as irrigation. Now irrigation can be done in two ways, like one is the traditional method like pulley system, moat, rahat, dekli, all these are what? All these are traditional systems, okay. And the modern systems are, which one are the modern systems? Like sprinkle system, drip irrigation, basins, all these are what? These are modern ways of irrigation, okay. Now we are going to move to the next one. This next keyword is kharif, okay. Now what is the meaning of kharif crops? Okay, so which crops are known as kharif? Those crops, or in short, you know, like those crops which need more water, and the crops which are grown in monsoon. Like these crops can also be known as monsoon crops, okay. So those crops which are grown in rainy season or monsoon are called as kharif. Okay, example, the very common one, rice. Okay, at the same time I will take rabi also over here. What do you mean by rabi? These are non-monsoon crops. Now these are non-monsoon crops. Example, wheat. Okay, I have taken both the points. I am discussing both the points here only. See, crops needs a particular kind of climatic conditions. They need a particular amount of water. They need a particular amount of sunlight. Okay, few need more sunlight, few need more water. So different crops need different kind of climatic conditions, and each and every climate cannot be suitable for all the crops. Okay, if you take an example, like if you try to grow rice, okay, in summer days, can you grow, can you do this thing? Can we do it? Is it possible? Just have a thought, be ready for the answer whenever these questions will come. Okay, so at for now, kharif crops are monsoon crops, and rabi crops are what? Non-monsoon crops. Okay, now come to the next one. The next one is manure. Okay, just now we have discussed about the fertilizer. Now we are going to discuss about the manure. Manure are what? These are organic compounds. These are what? Organic compounds. Okay, and it is made, let's see, it is made where? It is formed due to decomposition of dead and decaying material. Okay, now these are what we have discussed this thing in detail in our chapter. Many of the organic compounds, this can be made in the field itself. The farmers can made it. These are very good as it these are eco-friendly. They do not pollute the field. Then these are humus giving. Okay, these are what? These are very they improve the quality of the soil. They improve the aeration, the air, the amount of air which is taken by the plants, absorbed by the plants. It improves that. Hydration, that means water absorbing capacity of the soil is improved due to the manure. In long run, these manures are very fruitful. Okay, but only like there are certain disadvantages also, as these are bulky and heavy to store, to lift. Okay, and these even do not get dissolved in water very fast, as fast as the fertilizers get. And so it is like, this is the main problem. Like even the plants take more time to absorb manure, and when more time is taken to absorb manure, even the results are delayed. Like results are delayed in the sense what? Like results also, like you can see the results in long run. Okay, it's not a thing like you have added manure and like you will be able to see the results. Well, when we talk about fertilizers, the results are very fast. Okay, and manures are what? And what are manures? Manures are nutrient specific? No. Manures aren't, they are not nutrient specific. They give what? They provide whole kind of nutrients, like overall nutrients to the soil. Rather, fertilizers are what? They are nutrient specific. Okay, so this was about manure. We have discussed about the fertilizer also. Now we'll make a move to the next one, which is plow. Okay, now what it is, see, for growing the crops, yeah, it's correct, plow. So for growing the crops, we need to prepare the soil. Okay, prepare means what? First step has to be done. Like what is the first step? It is tilling the soil. Okay, loosening of the soil. So tilling and loosening of the soil is done with the help of what? Plow. Tilling of the soil is done with the help of plow. Okay, it can be of two types. It can be wooden plow and it can be iron plow. Okay, what is the meaning of tilling? Tilling means loosening of soil. Loosening of soil means what? Like bringing lower soil up and upper soil down. Like, it's what? Loosening, tilling of soil. So what happens to this? Why it is being done? It is being done so that the nutrients which are below can come up, can be used. Okay, the aeration can be increased, the roots, as the soil become loose, so roots can enter into the soil very properly and very easily. Okay, the minerals, the manures and fertilizers can get mixed up in the soil very properly. So these all are the reasons why tilling is done. Okay, and how tilling is done? It can be done by the plow, and this plow can be of two types. Like it can be of wooden plow, it can be wooden plow, it can be made up of wood, and it can be an iron plow. Okay, now next what we are going to take is rabi. Now rabi is already taken by us, so I'll skip this, I'll leave this. Now seeds. Now children, you will think how the seeds can be defined. Okay, so just let me write over here seeds. First I will write something and then we will discuss. It is a basic structure which give rise to a sapling if get all kind of favorable able to write over here. Okay, okay, so it is a basic structure. Okay, we all know how seeds are like this. It has a tough covering above it. It has all the nutrients inside it. It also has little amount of moisture inside it, which is required for the germination of the seed. If the seed doesn't has even, you know, like it doesn't has moisture into it, if it is totally dry, then it won't germinate. Okay, I told that in the last chapter, last lecture also, like how dry a seed can be by the 14% of its weight. Okay, so it gives rise to a sapling if it gets all kind of favorable conditions. Now what is the meaning of favorable conditions? Means a seed get germinate. What is seed? Seed is a basic structure, a small, like, which comes out from the fruit, and when it is sown in the soil, and if the seed is of good quality, definitely it is going to be, it is going to give a sapling. And what is required? Certain conditions are required. That means it will need space, it will need good quality of soil. In fact, the seed itself should be of good quality. Okay, a little amount of sunlight is required. Okay, light afterwards, like when the sapling comes out. So if it gives, if it gets all the favorable conditions, then a seed gets germinated into a sapling. Okay, now when we talk about crops, when the seeds are sown by the farmers, many things has to be kept under, you know, they have to keep in mind, like at what depth they are going to sow the seed. If it is at more depth, like the, it won't be able to germinate. If it is superficial, birds are going to take it away. Okay, if quality of seeds are not good, then what will happen? The seed won't germinate. Okay, if more water is there, then again seed won't germinate. If less water is there, again seed won't germinate. So like, you know, many things are there which has to be given a look if a farmer wants a better and a good crop. Okay, now we'll move to the next one, and the next one is silo. Now what are these silos? As we have discussed, granaries. Okay, now these silos are also kept in the godowns. But what are these actually? These silos are tall, okay, these are cylindrical structure which is or which are used to store the grains. And if you remember, we have discussed, it has different, like it has multiple openings, yes, so that a particular amount can be removed from this, okay. So silos, what it is, it is a tall cylindrical metallic, what is the meaning of metallic? Means it is made up of metal, metallic structure which is used to store grains, okay. It has multiple openings, okay. Means it can like it is very tall, it is made up of metal, a cylindrical structure which has more than one opening. Means it is not the case like if you open it once, the whole grain comes in contact with moisture, in contact with air. No, it has certain I have explained this, like suppose this is silo, so one opening, second opening and third opening. Means if this much quantity of grain is required, this can be open and can be removed. If this much is required, this both can be open and can the grains can be removed. Why is it so? So that the whole amount of grain doesn't comes in contact with the moisture and can be kept safely. It also protects the grains from rodents, from insects, okay, obviously from the temperature, moisture. Temperature, again it depends upon the temperature of the godown also, okay. Okay, now next is sowing. Next is sowing. Now, what is the meaning of sowing? Sowing means to okay. So we will talk about sowing. What is sowing? Sowing means the process of putting the grains inside the ground. Okay, what is sowing? Sowing means the process of putting the grains inside the soil. We have discussed this, like it can be done in many ways. It can be in one in the broadcasting method. What is one method? It can be done in the way of broadcasting. I'm not talking about any channel. Broadcasting means what? Just to spread, to throw the seeds like this only. And again, the another one can be seed drill. Now, what is a seed drill? An instrument which is used to what? For it is used for sowing the seeds. Now, come to the next one. The next one is storage. Okay. Now, see, this is very, very important part, storage. Okay. After the crops are harvested, okay, they need to be stored. They need to be stored at some safer place. Safer place means what? It needs to be very, very safe from the moisture, from the rodents, from the insects. Okay, can it be? I asked you this question. Can it be stored? Like, can the grains be stored as soon as it is cut? No. First, sun drying or mechanical drying. That means the grains can also be dried with the help of the electrical dryers. So, after drying, okay, after drying, what is being done after drying? Grains are kept in bags or silos. Okay, so this is what a way to store the grains. But again, as I told, the storage can be of two types. It can be dry storage and a cold storage. When you talk about dry storage, the grains has to be dried. That means their moisture has to be removed. Not totally, again I am telling you, 14% by the weight of the seed. Okay, it has to be removed so that the seeds can be stored properly. What will happen if the moisture is more in the seeds? See, first of all, if the moisture is more in the seeds, the size of the seed will also increase, which will again create difficulty. No, it will need more space, greater space will be required to store bigger grains. Okay. And second thing, again, if more moisture is present in the seed, again it will have a chance to get infected by the, you know, by the fungal or different kind of insects. Okay, so it needs to be prevented again by the different kind of insects. All these things has to be taken care of. And cold storage is done for which kind of foods? The one which has shorter life, okay, the one which has shorter life. I told you I cannot write over here, so I'll write just in short. The food items which has got shorter life, like milk, like pastries, cakes, chocolates, okay, and butter, okay, cheese, all these kind of products has very, very short life. It cannot be kept for a longer period of time. Okay, so this was about the storage. Now moving to the next one is threshing. See, you know, children, one thing I would like to tell you, in the NCERT, threshing and winnowing is explained as one only, that to remove the grains from the chaff. But you know, if you see, have a look in different books, you will understand that there is difference in threshing and winnowing. Threshing is to remove the grains from the stalk of hay, okay, and winnowing means what? To remove the grains from the chaff. So like, now it depends upon you, like which book you are going through, okay, but there is a bit difference in both the process. So we'll just have both the things together, threshing and winnowing. Okay, so let me write over here, threshing. What is the meaning of threshing? The process of removing grains from the stalk, or I can even write harvested stalk, okay, from the harvested stalk. Obviously it is a harvested stalk, there is no need to mention actually, but just to make it more simpler for you, so I can write over here, from the harvested stalk of the hay. Okay, and what is winnowing? Winnowing is what is the meaning of winnowing? To remove the grains, the process of removing the grains from the chaff. Once again, I would like to tell you, this point should not come in your mind that here I have taught something wrong. In different books, different things are given in a different way. In NCERT, threshing and winnowing is given as same only, but in actual there is a little difference in both. Okay, threshing means it is removed from the that particular stalk from where it is harvested, and winnowing means when you know like the grains are thrown down along with that bhusa, the chaff, the grains are heavier, and so it will fall down and the chaff will it will flow away, it will blow away. And what is done in the threshing? The animal help is being taken, animals are allowed to move, okay, on in the threshing process. And you know, I told you that the big logs are added at the back of the, like big logs are added to the animals, and when animals move along with animal, the logs which are tied at the back also moves. And what happened due to the pressure, the grains comes out from that particular stalk, that is threshing. What is winnowing? When all this bhusa and grains are all together, and when it is, when the heavier grains are thrown, when the grains are thrown, so what happened, the grains as they are heavier will fall down and the chaff will fly little bit away. Again, threshing and winnowing, like one machine which I told you before also, combine. Okay, combine is a machine. Okay, it is a machine which is responsible for doing all the things together. Like what it does together, it does harvesting also. Harvesting, threshing and winnowing. Okay, all these three things are done together. Okay, all these three things are done all together at one time with the help of this machine. Okay, come to the next one, weeds, weedicide and winnowing. I am going to discuss these three all together. Okay, now weeds. What is the meaning of weeds? These are unwanted and harmful. Okay, these are unwanted harmful plants which grows well along with the crop, which grows along with the crop. See, what are weeds? Weeds are those plants which grow along with the crop, and these are very harmful, and these are what, like unwanted, nobody wants them. Okay, these are unwanted guests, like there are few guests which come all together without inviting, like nobody wants them sometimes, I'm not saying always. So these are also like unwanted guests. And why they are harmful, and like first of all, few are there which release chemicals, toxic material, okay, which is harmful for the soil, for the crops and for the insects also, okay, for the for the whole thing, everything. Okay, now how it harms the crops. Why we doesn't want them? Because it has a competition with the crop. In which way they compete for the space, for the sunlight, for the water, for the nutrients. Okay, they all have, they compete with what the main crops. Okay, they first of all they are poisonous. And also compete with the main crops. For what they compete? They compete for sunlight. They compete for space, not able to write, and nutrients also. Okay, so these are unwanted and harmful plants which grows along with the crop. They are poisonous and also compete with the main crops in what way? Like sunlight, space and nutrients. These are weeds. Okay, these are what? Weeds. Now what do you mean by, what is the next one? Weedicide. What do you mean by weedicides? Weedicides are those chemicals which remove this weeds. Okay, this it has to be spread in the field. Okay, and what is weeds, weedicides and weeding? Okay, what is the meaning of weeding? Weeding means the process of removing the weeds. Okay, so I'll just have to rub, I'll rub these 2 points. Okay, so that the whole thing can come in one only. Okay, I'll just rub this too. So the whole topic, this one can come. Okay, these are weeds. Okay, now weeding. Now what is the meaning of weeding? If you remove this weeds, okay, so the process of removing weeds is weeding. Okay, what are weeds? Weeds are harmful plants which grow along with the main crops. These are poisonous. And also they compete with the main crop. In which terms and like how they compete, in what sense? They compete for the sunlight, for the space and for the nutrients. The process of removing the weeds, okay, is known as weeding. It can be done in 2 ways. First is manually, okay, first with the help of like, by like manually with the help of maybe khurpa or some kind, that kind of instruments. And second, by using weedicides. Now what is the meaning of weedicides? Those chemicals which kills the weeds. Those chemicals which kills the weeds. And these chemicals are also what? Chemicals are harmful for, not for the crop but for the farmers and for the like weeds. So they are meant to be harmful for the weeds. So these chemicals are harmful for the farmers . So should cover the face while spraying. See, this whole thing includes even one short note on weeds. If suppose there is a short note in weeds, we have to write what exactly weeds are, how it has to be removed. The process is known as weeding, and it can be removed in two ways: manually with the help of khurpa or some like other instruments, and even by using weedicides. What are weedicides? Weedicides are such chemicals, some chemicals which are used to remove weeds if it is spread on the crops altogether. I'm talking about when it is spread on the fields, the weeds, they die, they get like they are they automatically comes out of the automatic means they doesn't move out, but they are killed by such kind of sprays and the field gets rid of the weeds. Okay, now we'll discuss about the next one.